Welcome back to Rolling Solo and our Alliance playthrough part 3. And where we left off last is Algus had just finished his turn and we had a revenant show up in the spawning or dungeon master phase, I should say. And we had a revenant show up who, at the start of combat, all heroes in this room take one wound that can't be blocked or prevented by any means, then the revenant is removed from the dungeon. So essentially he's just going to chase us throughout the dungeon and then he's going to hit us and he's going to disappear and he's not going to give us anything. He's just kind of he's a jerk. There's no other way to say it. So essentially we're going to take all our dice back from Algus from the last turn, put them back in the center because they're no longer his. Now we are playing with Luke. He gets to gain his watch of played dice that he gets to roll when he decides to roll his dice. So in order to start the first round of the Alliance, our first turn of the Alliance for this episode, we're going to pull this over and we got ourselves a sinister wave. It says execute an extra dungeon master phase immediately. Now this is kind of insane. Now this is where, you know, maybe canceling the effects of an evil card is a good idea because we would have all kinds of pain coming at us. So what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to use the avert evil, which says play at any time, cancel the effects of a revealed evil card, and Algus is going to prevent this evil card from even happening. So that's kind of nice. He's cleared that up and one less thing to worry about for Luke anyway. So going back to Luke, he's in the medium room. He wants to be where he really does want to be where Algus is, but he also really doesn't want to hit that ghost because he's going to take a damage if he does. So maybe what we'll do is we'll actually move the board and he's going to explore kind of a little bit lower. Maybe kind of head towards the camera here and into a room below. So he's going to go ahead and use a step token, which is a free move and allows him to explore from this room going through this door. And it is going to be a treasure tile, which he knows is safe. And he's gonna land in here along with a coin that's potentially he can pick up if he docks a sword and a treasure chest. So he's kind of happy about that. We're also gonna grab another tile here to see if anything bad happens. And of course something does. Discard one treasure card and this room. Oh, that's bad. So if we go back over to Luke's treasure cards, he's got Frost Trap. Choose one room, any monsters in the room, do not move. Ooh, that's good. We want to keep that for later. During the Dungeon Master phase, this turn, you control the movement of all monsters. Remove all monsters from a single room, also very good. Chain Heal's really good, and Shield, oh wow, he's actually got some decent stuff here. You know what, I think the Shield one's got to go. I don't really want to get rid of it, but I think it's the one to go. So we're going to fire that one out the door. Discard that and reveal our next tile. Ooh, looks like another medium room is coming around the corner. So as of right now, Luke is inside the dungeon. In this small tile, he's found himself a treasure chest. And now we are going to pull. It looks like a bug. Some type of beetle. I don't know what it is exactly, so let's take a look. See if I can find a reference for it. It is a spider. Of course it's a spider. I shouldn't even have to look that up. So it does a web, and heroes can't leave a room with any spiders. So he just can't leave, essentially. And this spider is a 3 experience, but it does 2 attack and 4 damage. So now that we're in the room with the monster, we're going to have to, we will want to attack it to get rid of this stupid thing. So let's roll all of Luke's dice. And he's actually got some good stuff here for the most part. Got some magic, shield, bow, 2 potions. Might even hold on to a potion because he needs to heal one anyway. So we can keep that to the side. We'll keep one of the walking ones to the side. But we need to generate a lot of attack against this spider. He's got a defense of 4. And that's going to cause us to have to take this guy on and do some damage. Now, I've got 2 ranged and a magic, so what I could do is I could spend 2 bows, like so. Could take this magic, spend the magic in order to change the extra potion I have into a sword. Now the sword will go up here and it's going to dock into the luck favors the bowl, which gives him two sword symbols and a shield. Plus he has a shield on the board here remaining, along with a health potion and a movement. So he's generated four attack, but it's a mix of melee and range. So it's enough to kill the spider for sure. So this spider would die, but the spider is going to do its payback. Now this is where things get fun, because Luke just generated a... Oh, sorry for the blur there. Oh, let's focus back in, and the camera's wigging out. There we go. So Luke's got a shield there from Luck Favors the Bold, and then he's also got a shield over here. So he's going to dock this shield dice to give him the two shields that he needs to block the payback reaction of the spider. So in essence, the spider is now dead. He's taken the spider out, so we can fire that back in the bag. And if I remember correctly, because I just threw it in the bag like a crazy person, it has three experience on it. So he is going to jump up the track three experience. But it's negative one because he's in the negative one lane now for minor monsters, so he only gets two. But he does get to level up. So we go back over to Luke, and the only thing he can level up at this point, because this card's fully up, is the fluke. So he's going to give himself fluke, and now look at that. It actually generates a sword and some money, and he happens to have rolled an extra foot token. That's pretty handy. So the other thing that's kind of cool... Oh, I wish I had a sword. Oh, this is great. Never mind. I got too excited there. I thought I might be able to dock die and get the coin from the chest, but it doesn't look like I'll be able to do that, because I need an actual dice to be able to dock into that square there. So Luke is going to, he's definitely going to dock his movement die to give himself a sword he doesn't need, but it'll also give him three coins. So I'm going to pretend I've got three coins in my hand. You add that to the two he's already got, that's five. That is enough for him to purchase a new treasure card that he can add to his pile. He got Renounce. It's deal two wounds to a hero who gets to choose a card from the discard pile, and heroic sacrifice, take one wound to choose a card from the discard pile. That's not too bad. Don't need this anymore. So Luke's turn is done, and with that, I don't think there's anything else that he can do. The question is, did I take a treasure card for killing the spider? I don't think I did. So let's do that. He actually gets a treasure card for free for killing the spider. Now he's got bows, lots of bows, and that's good. So Luke is kind of going a little crazy. He's got almost a little bit of everything. And then, of course, we're going to spawn monsters. We're going to move monsters first, and how the movement will work is this monster here is just going to be in this room. This one just moves to whoever's closest, and it's obvious that August is the closest, so the ghost is going to go in here. And what will end up happening is when the start of combat, he's going to hurt August almost right away, which is kind of bad for him. And then we have to spawn the monsters now that the spawn token or tile is completely empty. And we got another spider. Damn spiders, stop. Okay, and he's got one extra dice he's got to use, so we'll just dock to the side and we'll take a coin for it. And that is the end of Luke's turn. So, at this point we've got, let's see, five of these in here. This ensures that we need to move the counter to five. And now we can reset Luke's step token. And we can say that that turn is in essence done. And we can steal all the dice back from Luke's character, except for the Watch It Played dice that he gets for free because he is very lucky. And we get to begin with a new evil card for August. New evil card for Algus is, it's a trap. All armed traps immediately activate. Also, you must dock one additional die of any kind to disarm a trap this turn. So this is kind of bad, but it's great at the moment because we don't have a single trap on or in the dungeon at the moment. So that's a good thing. The downside of this situation is that Algus has landed in a room with a lot of monsters, and he has to fight them before he can take any other major actions. He's allowed to do a few simple things, like using his losing some of his abilities to attack back, or using a lion's card, but he cannot just run away. He has to at least attack. So how the start of combat works with these guys is this guy here is a revenant. He just does a single point of damage and disappears, just like a ghost would do. So he pops in, he hits Algus for one, so we're going to lose a health. He's halfway down. The die gets thrown away, back into the bag. And now we deal with the threat who's going to stick around and fight, and that is the orc. So now things get interesting, because now Algus has to roll, and he's going to try to do his best to take this guy down. So we didn't really generate that many attack, and we need two, and it'd be nice to get a bow. So, and Algus also needs some potions really bad, so he's going to hold off and grab some, keep some potions. Maybe he'll even keep a shield for the chest in the room. And, oh, you know what? We got the magic. So you know what? Why don't we just use the magic and dock that die? We'll change this to a bow. Dock that for one bow or one ranged attack. And then use this other one for a ranged attack, which gives us two. Two is enough to take down the orc, which has a defense of two. So he is going to die. And by killing him, that allows Algus to actually jump from where he's sitting on the board now at 4 to 6, which isn't enough to level up, but it's getting closer. And he's also going to gain a treasure card for his kill, which is always a plus. He got some parry, and it shields up. That's good. He still has 3 dice left. So now we're going to take this dice, we'll fire this in the bag. And what we're going to do now is he's free to go ahead and make any actions or moves in that tile that he wants to, or with the rest of his dice. So he's going to go ahead and use his shield dice to dock. He's now broken open the chest, and he can take the coin and add it to his supply. Now he's got 3. Now, the one thing I noticed too is Alex has a step token. He hasn't used it yet. But at the same time, jumping into another room may not be a good idea, seeing as that he doesn't really have much in the way of attack. Even his cards aren't really good for attacking. So let's not do that. But let's dock these magic dice, or these potion dice, in order to bring his health points back up to 5. So that essentially would be Algus's turn in a nutshell. And really what I'm planning on doing, just so you guys kind of know, is August is running off in this direction. Luke's kind of coming down here, and I'm hoping to maybe have them kind of meet up over here somewhere is the idea. We'll see how that pans out. So anyway, that stuff is all settled. We've moved the counter. This card can be discarded. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 in, so this counter should move down to 6 now. And the other thing we have to do is move our monsters. Well, the spider is next to Algus, so he just keeps getting unlucky because he's near a spawn, and that's going to kind of continue to haunt him until he runs away. And now there is an even nastier individual lurking, and it is, I just need to double check who this guy is, I think it's a demon pitcher. Yep, demon pitcher. So he's sitting right there, and he does some damage if you don't have a feat token or move token or dice, I should say. So that's never good. All right, so that's that. And that is Albus's turn in a nutshell. So we'll take all these dice back over here. His token's already flipped. We're good to go. And now we'll move on to Luke. We got to add Luke's dice in to the pile and see what we're going to do with this guy. So what's the next evil card we're going to run to? Unnatural speed. All monsters have +1 move point during the dungeon master phase. So this is going to be kind of a pain when the dungeon, monsters in the dungeon are actually going to start moving and coming after us. That's going to be a problem. So Luke's over here with the chest. Chest is not that important. I'm going to really be looking for, actually, you know what, before we roll, this is not a roll, by the way. I'm going to flip the token and let's just explore into the medium-sized room we know is coming for free. So we're going to go up here, and that's way over here. So we're going to discard that tile, and we know that it's going to be a medium room, but we don't know what it is, and it doesn't look pleasant. So, move these cards down a bit, and we've got a medium-sized room right like so. So now we've just connected the dungeon a little bit. So Luke is gonna be able to move in here for free. That's gonna gain him an XP, because whenever you explore a medium room, you go up one XP. It looks like there's two minor monsters, so we're gonna grab two dice and drop them in here like so. Cultus, and it looks like Belial, I think, or, yep. And then we've got ourselves two coins underneath a chest. That's not bad. So Luke's kind of found a decent room here. He's gonna have to deal with a bunch of enemies, but if anyone's equipped to do it, it's probably him. Belial, he requires, or he can be killed with two potions. So when we go ahead and roll for Luke, we're gonna be looking for potions. And the cultist, he can actually be killed with, or he steals one potion die. Look at that. So he actually kind of helps to prevent that. That's kind of ironic, actually. So we got somebody who can be killed with potions, but yet the cultist steals one from us anyway. Now, before we go ahead and do a combat with this, we still have to remember to pull or flip this level one tile to make sure nothing happens, and it doesn't, so we're okay. So now we're gonna go ahead for Luke, and we're gonna roll his dice. And this is what we got. We got one potion. We're kind of looking for more potion. Magic is good. So maybe what we'll do is we'll hold on to that magic. We'll hold on to the bow. And we'll reroll the rest. And we're going to hope for more potion. Ooh, that did not turn out good. So, yikes. That really didn't turn out good at all. So, oh man, this is bad. Okay, so what's gonna end up happening is he's gonna lose the potion because the cultist has gone ahead and stolen that from him, so he's gonna go ahead and dock it as a lost dice. Now it's just a matter of figuring out how can we kill these guys. And let's go ahead and try to attack the cultist first. Oof, dangerous. No, let's go ahead and kill off Belial first. He looks like more of a pain. So we need three generated to kill him. I'm gonna dock my dice, my bow dice with Luke, and I'm gonna actually use Sudden Strike, which you can play during your turn to get two more bows. That's gonna give him the ability to ambush him and kill him without even giving him a fighting chance to even come back at us. So he's going to die. So he's dead. And then we're gonna resolve our second battle, which is with the cultist. The cultist is a 2-2. Now you can see this is where we're lacking with any kind of attacks, but maybe we have something over here in his cards that will allow us to help to take him down. These are for dealing, deal two wounds to a hero who gets to choose a card from the discard pile. Take one wound to turn. Ooh. You know what? I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna take Heroic Sacrifice. I'm gonna take one wound to choose a card from the discard pile. I'm gonna take Ambush back that I just played. And I'm gonna use the two bows of Sudden Strike to take this cultist down without him even being able to attack me. So I've essentially killed Belial and the cultist with little to no dice, really. So, because this is Luke and he gets minus one to any XP off the monsters he kills, even though these guys are two XP each, he's only gonna get one XP individually for each kill. So that's gonna push Luke to 16. So, both of these monsters are dead. They're back in the bag, but Luke also gains back two treasure cards. So even though he spent them, he ended up getting them back. Look at that, he got Ambush again, and he got Epiphany. And it looks like he can get some more XP, which I'm sure he needs at this point. So now he's got all this stuff here. What is the die that we need to dock to break the treasure chest? It is a sword. So I'm gonna use this magic dice. We're gonna dock this on Luke, and we're going to change the shield to a sword. And we're gonna put the sword in the dungeon. We're going to dock it here. It's going to break open the chest. He's going to take both the coins because he's a looter. And now that he's taken both of those coins, he is going to... Does he do something insane, like run to the next room? Don't know if it's a good idea. Now, the reason being is that we know in advance, based on having to pull the small tile, that it's going to be a mini room. So maybe it's not a good idea to do that and have a monster show up. But you know what? It's one extra tile deeper into the dungeon, and we've been playing pretty risky so far, so let's just do it. This may be not the wisest, but he's got a lot of alliance cards and treasure cards to help. So let's just take that risk and run out and hope that we don't regret this choice almost right away. So Luke's going to run out into this room, and he steps foot into the next room, and he's going to have to pull the tile to see if anything happens. Oh, there you go. Lucky Luke's luck has hit a snag. So we're going to put this trap here right beside him, and that automatically gives Luke a smack. So he knocks down 4, and we're going to have to pull another tile and hope that it's not another trap. Oh, look at that. We found the stairs. So these are the stairs to the second level. So in order to finish up this turn, so we can finish up this video and then maybe move into the next video with us going into level 2 potentially, Luke's moved into this room, so he's going to have to deal with some random magical monster. And it's just a goblin. So not too bad. And we know that goblins, they do a quick stab. They perform his attack even if he's killed by range attacks. So he's going to be kind of a pain, but he's only a 1. So he's really not that bad. And what we're going to end up doing actually is we're just going to... Oh, sorry. The goblin actually isn't in the trap room. He's in here. So what we're going to actually do is we're going to just use his one shield. And that's just going to block it. So like essentially he attacked us, but we just block him anyway. So like nothing ever happened. He's just more of an annoyance essentially at this point. So now what happens is the turn is done. We know down here that we had unnatural speed pulled for the evil cards, that all monsters have +1 move point during the dungeon master phase. Well, it doesn't really apply because all the monsters are within a space. But so what is this guy's name again? The demon pitcher, he's just going to move himself into the room with the spider. And it looks like Algus is going to have his work cut out for him in the next video, did I just realize that I left a dice on Algus's tile that I didn't roll for Luke? Oh my goodness. Well, let's just, I think I did so. And if I did, let's roll it. Oh, look at that, it's a potion. Perfect way to end it. So we're going to drop the potion in there, and Luke's going to gain back a health because I had accidentally left that. I didn't roll it with Luke when I should have. I left it for Malgus's turn. But anyway, back to the story. The monsters had moved into each small tile as I just did, and now we have to go ahead and we have to spawn for each spawn room that doesn't have a monster currently in it. We got ourselves a gargoyle. So that's something different, something new that we're gonna have to kind of look at. And we'll find out more about that in the next video. And so in order to get ready for the next video, we'll just flip Luke's token back over. We're going to bump up the round token.